Hi everyone, today we're going to be discussing Google Scholar and how to conduct a basic search. First, I'm going to tell you a little bit about Google Scholar. So Google Scholar is a freely accessible web search engine. I'm sure you're familiar with Google, but this is a little bit different. Google Scholar provides a simple way to broadly search for scholarly literature, such as journal and conference articles and academic books. It does not search for popular magazine or newspaper articles. Google Scholar also tracks how often an article has been cited. It's important to note that unlike normal Google, Google Scholar will not show results for web-based articles, online websites, etc. It is really just looking for scholarly literature. Now I'm going to show you a live demo of how to conduct a basic search in Google Scholar. We're now on the Google Scholar homepage, which is found at scholar.google.com. We're going to be conducting a basic search on the topic of distance learning. You can just type in your two keywords and hit search. Now you can see we have some limiters on the left. However, we do not have a limiter for full text. This is important to note because in the EGCC library, you can filter results by full text, meaning you'll be able to read full versions of your results. In Google Scholar, however, you may not be able to read the full text of the books and articles in your list. However, if you see a PDF or HTML link here on the right, that's a good indicator that you do have access to the full text. We can click on this one, for instance, and it opens automatically the full text of the article. Google Scholar does give a few options for filtering your results. You can filter by a specific year range or articles published from a specific year. You can sort your results by relevance or by date. If you sort by date, the most recently published articles and books will populate at the top. There is also an Includes Citations checkbox, which you can check or uncheck. This simply will get rid of the results that are simply citations, as opposed to full text, etc. So it really doesn't affect our list too much. There is this cite tool that gives you a citation for different formats. However, you will want to double check these to make sure there are no errors. You can look on sites such as Purdue OWL or Citation Machine. Now let's look at our list at a couple different tools to use to find relevant articles. There's this Cited By tool. Notice how it says Cited By 348. This means that 348 other works have cited this particular article. If we click on this link, we're taken to a list of all of the scholars, all of the experts who have cited this article in their own scholarly work. This is a great tool for finding relevant articles related to your topic of interest. You can also search within this list of articles. Let's say we were looking for only distance learning in a university setting. We could search for the word university and filter our results list down a bit to find those that focus on universities. The other tool I want to show you is the Related Articles tool. If you click on Related Articles, you will see a list that, using its algorithms, Google Scholar has populated for you. These articles will be on related topics to distance learning and distance education. So those are two really important tools in Google Scholar. Google Scholar is a great tool and it's free to use, but be sure to also combine this with searches in the EGCC library. If you have any questions about Google Scholar or about accessing library resources, please reach out to us via email or click on the gator at the bottom of our homepage to start a live chat with a librarian. Thank you for watching.